Alex Jones, our guest tonight, is an artist who started out as the bad girl at school,
but ended up top of the class, so much so that the Prime Minister says he wants her to paint him. It's Tracey Emin.
Where would you start with the Prime Minister then? How would you paint him, Tracey?
Well, it's lucky I'm not Eve Klein, because Eve Klein would have painted the Prime Minister blue and naked.
Right.
That could be tricky, yeah.
Right.
No, I think I'd probably want to do some drawings of him first of all. But the first time I met the Prime Minister, he did tell me that himself.
Did he?
And my thing, because I do a lot of sewing, which is really painstaking and slow and laborious, I sort of said, well, if he wants to spend 6 months in my studio while I do an embroidery of him, fine, but I'm sure he's got other things to do. So.
Well, that's kind of a special cover of David Cameron. Okay, so Tracey, just 99 days to go now until the Olympics, and you're one of the artists that's designed some of the posters there. Oh, this one is for the Paralympics.
Yeah.
And now that is just beautiful. Look at that. You inspire
so nice.
Me with your determination. And I love you.
Yeah, it's a good message, isn't it? And the determination and the inspiration are words which are actually motto words for the Paralympics.
Yeah.
And what I'm really thrilled about is my poster is the designated poster for the Paralympics. So that's what the Paralympic Board chose. So if any literature, anything historic, it will be my poster that's used for the 2012 Paralympics.
Wow,
so I was really, really thrilled with that. Yeah, it was great.
Brilliant. Yeah.
Well, Tracey has also taken art a whole new level because she was the driving force behind an amazing new concept for a fleet of Olympic planes. There they are. I will be chatting to Tracey all about that project a little bit later on.
They are just beautiful. Now, for any youngster growing up with an adult who has a drink or a drug problem, life can be pretty tough.
Yes, according to a new report, perhaps as many as 3.5 million children live in a household affected by addiction. Hayley Cutts meets one remarkable family.
Most of the time when Mum and Charlie or Ellie were arguing, it would just...
So, I want to ask you something. Everyone knows you share the sofa.
Yes.
But in the studio, I've heard that you actually share a bed. Is that true?
Hang on.
Hang on a minute now.
It is actually factually correct.
Basically, I've moved house and I'm sleeping in Matt's sofa bed.
Oh,
but
yeah.
That sofa bed is now in my
it's
house.
Actually in Alex's house.
It's Matt's bed and I sleep in it, but not in the same house.
There it is as well. There's
the bed. Oh, that's embarrassing.
What is as embarrassing as mine, which half the world saw, so...
And it just,